Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to another Propaganda Cast Total War Rome 2 episode. We're off here with the continued Roman conquest of, well, the civilized world. Because obviously anything beyond this isn't civilized at all. Anyone who says otherwise is a liar. But no, we're dealing here with some Macedonians and the likes. Some troublemakers, but mostly the Macedonians have pretty much sort of been, well, wrecked. They don't have a lot left, and overall the forces of Rome are quite overwhelmingly strong at this point, controlling most of the areas quite solidly. There's not really much there sort of going on. I think I'll build another fleet in part because what I needed for my final goal there of a military victory, and for that we kind of need more fleets, so with sufficient resources we'll actually go for that now. Instead of building a navy there, a second one. Got some troublemakers here and there to deal with, but overall next goal will be the Seleucid Empire. I'll probably get a bit trickier. Probably. That'll be something I'll have to be dealt with once we get there. If they can't get some half decent auxiliaries out of here and sort of push towards the east. Alright, we already got that, but there might be something better in Egypt, or different at least, since those are two rather different regions originally. There's a bit going on there. Roads also needs to be dealt with alongside some other bits. We'll take that sort of in smaller steps there. Of course, we also got the war there we need to take care of. Almost forgot about that one. Of course, we've got our forces here. I mean, theory could go to war with the 80, but I don't think there's been much to be gained from that. We also need to prepare for a conquest of England. So I guess I'll have to begin raising legions for that, actually, at some point in the nearby future. Anything over here? Nope. Well, in that case, I think we end the turn. Oh. A few people to promote. One spy. A great effort of spying at stuff. And one legion here, the first legion. Italica. There we go. Now we end the turn, then we see what happens next. It looks like they're getting ready to march on Knossos or Knossos. Maybe, maybe not. Hard to say what exactly they're planning. They're a bit of a loose cannon now without, you know, any actual hometown, and they're basically dying from attrition. Alright. Big attack here. They actually got an awful lot of artillery. I think I'll pull back a bit.
Journey completed.
Alright, still a bunch there. But at least less troops. Plus, I believe this is a river crossing they're going to attack across. That's going to be beneficial to me as well. So, right, let's do this and hope we don't muck it. Plus, I do believe the Orians. So, also be quite handy. Plus, we got a lot of cavalry plus some archers. Yeah. They're actually pretty close to each other, meaning it's going to be pretty easy to come. I mean, they got artillery. But they have to advantage of that, so. I think pretty well. I mean, they're going to basically be bunching up, so any artillery just raining down on them is going to be pretty battle, for example, just for that. Yet, Transdanubia is going to be a lot bloody easier. Of course, the magical question is, where the hell will they be attacking from? Crossing, breach, both, who knows? Be setting up sort of here. Even the cavalry in one sort of massive reserve, they could sort of attack where we need be. And if they sort of go for one, we just sort of flank about them with the cavalry around the other one. Again, noble horse, actually the cavalry, all very good. Praetorians are basically sort of an additional sort of extra here. Oh, there's a principate.
Jupiter gives us strength.
Ah, crap, I didn't get them upgraded. That's awkward. And those won't protrans optically. Well, that's awkward. We'll see where they attack. And that's going to be the magical question. And all Earth to the attack.
Enemy reinforcements approaching.
Seems like it's over here. They got their own artillery. They might be hitting numerous crossings here. We got the reinforcements coming there. Pretty sure I didn't order you to move, but that somehow ended up being the case anyways.
We are losing ground.
Setting up the artillery for that. I'm still going to set the kill zone there. Getting some kills. Looks like the carrier there took a few solid whacks. Set up for counter artillery duties instead. That might end up making a bit more sense in this case.
Ballista!
And they're bunching up pretty close to the artillery, so that should kind of work out. Ish. I suppose I should have fallen back further, but that's too late now. I still got my ace, of course, which is still a ton of cavalry. We need to fire that there, chaps. Connecting me a lot closer, so that's excellent. There you go, one silenced already. Another down. Quickly silencing their artillery, which pretty much. Well, they got one over there, but that's not going to be so much of a problem once we can silence with the main artillery force. Down to two there, we've still got the other four. Can hit, that is. Actually, let's change targets for a bit. They're basically bunching up for the bridge, so right now, not shooting at them. It's going to be a bit silly. Just at least a few volleys. For maximum carnage hit. Just look at all those targets.
Hidden units have been discovered.
It's pretty much a kill zone. Damn well better shooting. So far I'm not seeing a lot of that from you, chaps. Pretty much the other one that's doing all the killing there. Back to silencing artillery, I think. Got the archers firing.
See you in the afterlife.
So far, the artillery is having markedly little effectiveness because they're using the explosive stuff, which is pretty rubbish, to be honest. Now the silence.
Our hidden units have been discovered.
One of our units has used all its ammunition.
So I'll send down the Principes there. Counter attack. Set up for a cavalry flank.
Mount the deck! Cavalry!
Other unit there dead, splendid.
Legionaries!
Some of the legions, then sledgehammer them with a cavalry. Shooting those shots in this case, the cavalry.
Take hell,
the men are wavering.
Sons of Mars.
There we go, quickly routing those chaps. Actually, keep moving, maintain momentum. Don't stop up. Can't manage numerous battles here.
Battle ready.
That's been dealt with. Head up for the flank, and then we sort of crash them that way. That should free up the legionnaires for the other side. Then we could swing the cavalry up for there, clear out the rear elements. Okay, they're being a bit more stubborn there. The sneaky little gits. Looking a bit rough here.
Our men flee the field of battle.
Come on, just break. Rome orders you to break, ya twerps. Close.
Our men flee the field of battle. This is a shameful display.
Go. Almost.
Our general is under attack.
Yeah, so now he's under attack. There's general, not much you can do about it at the moment. Gotta commit him or it's all lost anyways. Shift the legionnaires. Leave the carrier to mop up the remainders.
One of our units has used all its ammunition.
General! Quickly now! Noble horse! Take charge!
No, that way! That way, to where the fighting actually is, primarily.
Warriors, eager for blood.
Our men flee the field of battle. This is a shameful display.
At speed.
Might need a single legionary unit that's set again.
Our men flee the field of battle. This is a shameful display.
Flank him. Crush him.
General.
men flee the field of battle. This is a shameful display.
Well, I might have gotten 2 hour confident here, but that's too late now to sort out. At least they can always replace the legionnaires, which was one of the strengths of Rome. Even if they did lose a legion, they could quickly replace it. So I'm going to rely on that strength.
Our men flee the field of battle. This is a shameful display.
Withdraw! So yeah, that's ultimately falling apart here.
Hunters!
I'll probably end up doing a ton of damage to them. And they're going to have a harder time replacing it than I will, replacing a single legion lost. That's pretty much my advantage here.
Men flee the field of battle. This is a shameful display.
At this point, I don't think there's much left of it altogether. I mean, the units are basically falling apart.
Our men flee the field of battle. This is a shameful display.
And there we go. But they lost a lot, almost 3,000. I'm replacing all of those losses. Comparatively, I can pretty rapidly put out a new legion. In fact, I got another one already on the way being prepared there. It shouldn't be too far off.
Retreat, men! Retreat!
Now that one apparently can... Nah, can't. Still, some pretty heavy losses suffered by them. We'll of course conquer them and so on.
I offer this mort.
Nope.
The best ale is off.
Knossos, they're not doing too well against the Macedonians. They'll actually be the... Well, those chaps, much easier for me to just take off. Someone got an assassinator, that's lovely. That is lovely.
At your command. Ready for battle. Your next command.
Right. Front some extra legionnaires. After that, Nessa, I'll just throw in mercenaries and rush that up there. Guess we'll raise another here. The 8th Legion.
Rome needs good fighters.
Quickly putting together sort of a core unit there.
Ready for battle. We hunger for battle. Ready for battle.
Getting ready for the next war. Just need a bit of time here and there to get it all set up and going. Ready for orders. Walk Auxiliary hoplites. Not that they're really a lot better, but let's try a few up just for the hell of it, see what happens before we then sort of push against the Galatians. My northern forces that are getting, I would say, pretty extended, so I'll... Well, I need to clear out the seas first of a hostile fleet, but I might probably then transfer to shift the fleet or an army northwards. I'll have to use my navies for that. This one should be in a reasonably good condition to help deal with whatever Macedonia's got there, so I can clear those out and then can sort of get a fleet or an army shifted northwards. We got like five down here. Probably not quite necessary. But you can see I'm now finding a much more extended front up northwards, so more legions there might initially help out a bit further. And I'll still keep that on here in case the Raeti pull off something. That's pretty much my guarantee in case something goes slightly pear-shaped there, or they just decide they want to be all cool. In which case I'll be more than happy to remind them they aren't. So that is that. Still have some time before we hit that one though. 8 turns, we of course hope to boost it with a bit more archives and the likes. They're getting suicidal. No, I'm complaining. That just means the whole cleanup job is going to get a lot easier. That means the whole cleanup job just got a lot easier. I might actually be able to seize that one pretty quickly. In fact, I might use the armor I'm shifting northwards to first seize Knossos, just for the hell of it, because, well, they don't actually have a lot left guarding it, and I think that might just have been it. Can't quite locate their other unit, army, or whatever. So, keep the fleet nearby just in case. Northwards there. There and we strike there. Move eastwards to join up there, and you move eastwards as well. I think should largely cover it. A few more veteran legionnaires there. At your command. And you head northwards. We'll throw in some mercenaries. Mesha. You have further orders. Ready for orders. The other one together as fast as possible. It is a great and glorious thing to die for Rome. Legion northwards as well to assist for the time being. Commander. Got Sinova over there. We're at. Aren't we supposed to be at war with us? Oh, it's Persia, not Parthia. Those are two different entities. Right. Those are two different entities. Good to know. Make haste, men! Right, that allows us to set up for that next turn.
We hung.
hunger for battle.
Well, don't think there's so much else to do besides raise another legion, I guess. Got many armies more. I can make 3 more, so that's probably going to be a pretty good idea. But the question is, where do I raise it? Where do I raise it? Guess we'll do it here.
Ready? Get to it, men. Soldiering, it's a good life.
There you go.
We hunger for battle.
Macedonia. Right, that's looking pretty good. That should allow us overall to get a lot more fighting power. In fact, I might just rush this one further north so we can quickly get it up there.
It is a simple gift, gold, but one that many appreciate, as we are sure you will.
No thanks.
Hermes would surely bless you if trade between our peoples was allowed. Do not annoy the gods.
How much do they like us? I'm planning on taking it anyways. Again, I briefly consider maybe having them as a client state, but just again, they're rebelling and they just love doing it. It's pointless. Looks like someone thought I was weak. That's going to be something they will end up quick regretting.
Fleet reporting.
Oh, we can take that one with just a fleet. Splendid.
It is an honor to serve Rome.
Oh, that's ours now. Most gloriously so. Dead.
We hunger for battle.
For the capital of Ancyra as well, Ancyra. And that one is swiftly seized as well. The Galatians ultimately cannot resist the might of Rome. Taken, Diospolis. had a lot of citizen carrying other bits, but nothing before sizable Roman legion. And the capital turned out to be nowhere near as well guarded. And the asleep pretty quickly fell. Egypt and Blemius. So that's pretty much all Egypt's got left as predicted. Do have a sizable army hiding about there. That is Rapidus East. Oh, those chaps joined in. That's a problem. That's actually kind of a problem. I have to shift units up there. And I'll obviously have to punish those chaps for thinking they could get away with doing that to Rome. The arrogance, the hubris. So they will very quickly find themselves dealing with several large Roman punitive forces. I teach them a very important lesson. Only I get to declare war. Go. Expansion continues at a very rapid pace. Very rapid pace. And so does the raising of new legions. I'll actually be rushing that one down there. It's within range. Oh, wait, they've actually expanded. Oh, bollocks. Not see that. Well, you actually then head back up there. We need to counterattack there in case they break through up north. So the raiders actually begin losing out to them. You cowards, you useless bastards. Why do you think I didn't go to war with you to keep everybody else away from me? Gotta do everything yourself, it seems. Gotta do everything else. Gotta do it all yourself. But there you go. Some bit more time to go there, but we'll soon be there. We'll soon be there. We shall soon then have glorious legionary cohorts, armored legionnaires, and Praetorian guards and Praetorian cavalry. All the heart desires. Might set up Ancyra some kind of military outpost here around Cappadocia. Prove quite handy. Could prove quite handy. Batarium, those in for a bad day. Not much you can do about that now. Except punish the Boci for their sins against Rome. Not sure as I'll make them regret that. I think that sort of largely covers that. Wait, we've got some we can train up. All the way up there. Go, end the turn. Another suicide assault. Depleted units versus nicely rested legionnaires behind walls. Even a contest. Not even a contest.
I offer this morsel. Now, like a wolf at the door, perhaps you will go.
Nope. Nothing like that here. Just glorious Roman victory. And civilization. Seems like an army for that. Up there, just stop by briefly and deal with it. And there we go.
Ready for order. We cannot sail there.
And we continue towards Cedar. And Iconium. Be a target. Roman conquest.
Besieging settlement. Our advance has been halted. Lay siege to the settlement.
Apparently a lot more resistance here than anticipated. I wonder from what? It's like that, yes. Where the hell are those, though?
Let
can't
them cower
really see
Rome.
Them, but I guess that's a part
Ready
of the trick here.
March. Your next command? That is impossible.
There we go. And there we go. Using superior numbers, we crush them.
Commander.
I just really dislike fighting town city battles there in Rome.
Commander.
That's if I always auto-resolve them.
Set up the watch.
But there you go. They have quickly lost ground.
At your command.
Sending them up north. And here.
Ready for battle.
You know that. Still a lot to do here. Oh, they were moving ahead there, so that's even easier. Now then, back to what I was actually trying to achieve here. A lot of food here, by the way. A lot of food, a lot of grain farms. Obviously, Egypt was the Roman Empire's breadbasket. So, I think that sort of largely covers it. Got a lot here. Huge chunks of land, huge tracts of land. Once we dealt with the boy, we can probably shift some of those legions towards here, then prepare for the invasion of England. But I think we're stopping here, so thank you all for joining in. I hope you enjoyed today's episode. If you didn't subscribe, like, share, and comment on it. This is Imperial Dane saying cheers. Thank you all, and see you all another time. And well, that is 2 days' time. Cheers.